President Obama made $400,000 a year as president. Now he commands that much for a single speech. Charlie Gasparino over at Fox Business revealed yesterday that Obama will be paid $400,000 to speak at a conference put on by the Red Cross. Oh, just kidding. By the Wall Street firm Cantor Fitzgerald. Quite the shift for the man who once said this.
I did not run for office to be helping out a bunch of fat cat bankers on Wall Street.
But he left office in order to do that. Is Obama's cash in the latest proof Democrats have become the party of the super rich? Zach Pacanzas is DNC senior advisor, and he joins us now. So, obvious question, Zach. What could the former president possibly say, A, that we haven't heard, B, that would be worth $400,000 for an hour? What's he saying?
First off, I just want to set the record straight. I'm actually a former DNC senior advisor, not current.
Well, I think in spirit, you're still speaking.
Well, thank you very much, Tucker. I appreciate that very much. Let me be very clear. When we judge President Obama in terms of what his record is on Wall Street, I think we should look to the policies that he has passed, and that is the Wall Street reform, which is a key measure that reined in the abuses of Wall Street to ensure that what happened to the economy never happens again.
Oh boy, you fell right into my trap.
I was going to wait
to hit you with the facts until the end of the segment, but here we go.
All right.
Under President Obama, the Dow Jones Industrial Average rose 140%. Now, that did not benefit everyone equally in this country of 325 million. The top 1% share of income rose from 17% to 22%. In other words, the majority, the overwhelming bulk of the wealth created under President Obama went to people who are already rich. This has been much decried. Bernie Sanders ran a whole campaign on this.
Sure.
So to say that he crushed Wall Street is like ridiculous.
No one is saying that he crushed Wall Street, but if you're saying that Wall Street executives like the Wall Street reform legislation, you have another thing coming.
Well, so
Not only do they hate it, but the Republicans are unveiling a new piece of legislation next week to repeal that piece of legislation, which is backed by the Wall Street banks. It is a wish list for the Wall Street banks. And so if you're asking which of the party is for the Wall Street banks, and which of the parties against the Wall Street banks, we're the party against
really,
the Wall Street
banks. How much do you pay if you make a lot, 40% income tax, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the top rate. Someone in private equity working a regular job, 9 to 5 like you, what does he pay? He pays half that. And you know why he pays half that? Because something called carried interest. It's a loophole the Obama people left in for 8 years. And it allowed the richest people in our country to pay half the tax rate you pay.
You know what's not going to fix that? You know what's not going to fix that? Well, the tax reform legislation that this administration is now pushing.
Then I'll be the first to bark about it.
You should be barking about it right now because they put out the details of it. And what it is a big wet kiss to the super rich, to the wealthy, to corporations.
How could it be?
How
could it be wetter than the kiss that the Obama administration gave her? Look, you know
this was the whole point of the populist backlash
by Bernie Sanders against the Democratic Party. It is the party of the rich, and that's why rich people voted for it. What do you think? By the way, what do you think?
Do you know what the margin
was for Hillary Clinton on Nantucket? I'll tell you.
It was 64 to 29.
The affluent in this country, look, I'm not against rich people at all. I'm merely saying the Democratic Party represents them in a way it never has.
Donald Trump has appointed five, not one, not two, not three, not four, but five Goldman Sachs executives to key senior posts within the White House. Hmm. These are the people that are actually writing economic policy for this administration, Goldman Sachs executives.
Yeah, that's true.
So if you want to talk about which is the party that is pro-Wall Street, just look at the cabinet for Donald Trump.
But look, I think he's hired an awful lot of Goldman people.
A lot of Goldman people.
I agree with that. In the run-up to the election, private equity firms and hedge funds put a lot of money into this campaign. Okay, so for Hillary Clinton, they put in about $48 million. For Donald Trump, they donated $19,000 total. $19,000 to $48 million. So why don't we just acknowledge the reality that exit polls prove there's been a massive shift in the last 20 years. The Democratic Party is once the party of working people, wage earners, and now, and it's provable with the numbers,
it is provable with the policies. Hillary Clinton was the only candidate in the race that was calling for reining in the abuses of Wall Street. Donald Trump, on the other hand, was talking about busting Wall Street reform
that was reining in the abuses. Can we return to the beginning of the conversation and get a satisfactory answer? $400,000 for an hour. Now, I'm not against people giving speeches for pay. I think it's great, okay? But $400,000 an hour begs the question, what exactly is he selling?
But you should ask President Obama.
You've represented him.
Let me be very clear. As I said from the very beginning, I don't care.
You really don't care?
What I care about is what policies you push while you're in office.
Well, I don't know.
And Barack Obama was not a friend of Wall Street business executives.
Are you joking?
Donald Trump is.
No, but
that is an objective fact.
I think it's possible to argue that the tax reform on the table will not be what the president campaigned on. We'll see. But you can't argue, that President Obama did not do the bidding of Wall Street banks.
I can't.
They supported him overwhelmingly.
Otherwise, we wouldn't see Wall Street reform on the books, which the Wall Street CEOs do not like, which they have campaigned against, and which the Republican Party, which is in their pocket, is looking to
reform. So why did they give so much money to Hillary Clinton?
I have no idea.
You have no idea.
I have absolutely no idea.
Why did they pay her for all
those? Were so antithetical to their interests, so I have no idea.
They just don't know what their interests are. That's why they've made billions, because they have no idea where the money is. Is that what you're saying?
I think like others.
Because they're just stupid. They're just stupid.
I have absolutely no idea. What I do know is that Hillary Clinton had the strongest platform to rein in the abuses of Wall Street of any candidate.
All right, we're almost out of time, Zach, and you're doing a robust job as always.
Thank you. It's a tough side.
Let me just ask you this.
Please,
for the third time.
Sure.
Can you look right in the camera and say, I'm totally fine with President Obama taking $400,000 from Cantor Fitzgerald for a speech?
In the camera?
Yeah, go ahead.
I am totally fine with the President of the United States passing Wall Street reform that reins in the abuses of Wall Street.
It's indefensible, Zach. There you go. And you just made that point clearer than I ever could. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Tucker.